Hey. Okay, so for this video, I am going to do my foundation, my concealer, and all of that fun stuff. So here we go. All right, so you can obviously see my acne scarring, my dark circles, because my kids have decided this week that they're not gonna sleep. So, you know. First things first, and this is in the new Pretty Royalty bottle. It's the rose water. What's it do? All kinds of amazing things. I use it every day as a toner, first thing. I also use it as a setting spray at the end. So it's a very fine mist. It smells amazing. So, okay. I just kind of mist it on there. And let it dry a little bit. Helps keep that oil and stuff at bay. And it's got, yeah, I mean, rose water is like super duper good for your skin. So that's awesome too. All right, and then I'm gonna come over here to the Glorious Face and Eye Primer. It's the same primer that we've all come to know and love. They just repackaged it. And again, just a pea size. And you just kind of put it all over. Just like that. I'm jamming to some 90s, so, I mean, Backstreet Boys are on. Sorry if I break out and dance. Don't judge me. Okay, so while that's drying, I'm gonna show you the different kinds of foundation. Obviously, we've all heard all kinds of stuff about this. This is the Liquid Touch Mineral Foundation. It's been called Photoshop in a Bottle. So it has a glass dropper and glass bottle. Whenever you get it, you'll want to empty it all out every morning before you put it on and give it a little shake. It's mineral, so it can settle, and you want your foundation to be consistent. If you don't do it, you can either get like really thick or really thin liquid. So there's that one. This is the BB Flawless. This is my summer color, so it's fairly dark. I say that like I get really tan. And so it just takes a little bit and you just put it all over. You can use your fingers, you can use a liquid foundation brush. I do find myself wanting more coverage because of, you know, all of my scarring and stuff like that. So I mix it in a little bit of liquid concealer together and apply it with the liquid foundation brush. So that's how I do that one. We also have a cream foundation. You can use it with the sponge that comes with it, which, you know, judging by that, I obviously do. Or you can, again, use the liquid foundation brush. Well, it's just the foundation brush. And then we have the pressed powder, which is what I'm going to use. So let's get going here. I'm dry now. I'm sitting on the floor because my lighting's really good right here. Okay. So this is the liquid concealer. I use Scarlet, which is the lightest shade. In the summer, I get to where I'm about chiffon color. And then in the winter, I'm organza. I'm getting pretty close to there right now. So, just a teeny tiny bit. Like, for real, a teeny tiny bit. And the trick with concealer is to grab your blending bud, get it damp, squeeze all the water out, and you want to pull it down away from your eyes. I really need to practice doing this without opening my mouth all goofy. Like, you know, we all do it, but it's one thing to record a video of yourself doing it. Do you see the difference there? Like, the redness is, like, immediately gone. And so are those dark circles. Heck yeah! Whoop whoop! Okay, so now the point of pulling it down like I did is that if you go straight underneath your eye, you're actually going to draw attention to those fine lines, those dark circles. So if you pull it away, you're essentially highlighting your face. Okay, so let's get over here to this powder foundation, shall we? I'm going to use the sponge. Okay, just kind of swirl it in there a little bit. Look at that. Have you ever seen a powder that covers like that? I can see you, Brent Matthew. Look at this part of my skin compared to the rest. Like, look how flawless this looks from a powder. Ta-da! Okay, so there's that. So now, some days I contour and highlight my face, but not every day. And I do already have a video on that. So I'm gonna skip that step and I'm gonna do bronzer and blush. My hair's acting kind of crazy. Flat. I have way too much hair for it to be flat. It's ridiculous. Okay, anyways. The ADD is kicking in there. Okay. So this is our blush brush. It is angled and big and fat and poofy. This is the blush color I'm going to use. I know it looks intense, right? So the big secret with it, that's it. Our blush is so pigmented, it barely takes anything. So just teeny tiny bit. Look at that. Isn't that a pretty color? And it looks so scary right here. Ta-da! All right. And then for bronzer, I'm gonna use my powder puff brush. Just a little swirl. And we're gonna make a 3. So for those of you who have or have tried to highlight and contour your face, essentially with bronzer, you're doing the exact same thing. Throw a little on my nose there. Have you ever seen those girls with the bright orange cheeks, like they just put a ton of bronzer on their cheeks? That's why we do the 3. It's to kind of give yourself a natural glow, a natural sun-kissed look. So, anyways, that was the rose water primer, concealer with a blending bud, And then I put on pressed powder foundation. The blush color I used was Stunning. And I used our blusher brush. And then I did the Beachfront Bronzer in Sunset. And for that, I used the Powder Puff brush. All right, ladies, that's that video. Have a good one.